Alright, so my name's Haley. I'm an early and special education major, so I'm going to talk to you about something that touches home with the special ed side of things, which is the R word. So the problem is that the use of the word retard is being used to describe things and people in a negative way, which is obviously not necessary when there's so many words out there in the world that we could be using instead. So I'm going to talk to you guys about the problem with the word, Rose's Law, and spread the word to end the word. So the problem with the word is that there are 6.5 million people in the world who have an intellectual disability, which is the appropriate term to use. And so whenever you use the word negatively, you're putting those 6.5 million people in a category that's not very kind. And so from my survey, 91% of you know someone who has a disability, and 66% of you have used that word negatively. And so I just challenge you to think about this more the next time you go to use that word and think of those 6.5 million people or maybe just the one person that you have met or come in contact with. And so also from the Daily Journal of the United States government, they said, advocates for individuals with intellectual disabilities have rightfully asserted the term mental retardation has, advocates for individuals with intellectual disabilities have rightfully asserted the term mental retardation has negative connotations, has become offensive to many people, and often results in misunderstandings about the nature of the disorder and those who have it. So when you use that word, it's incorrect and creates a misunderstanding for that group of 6.5 million people. So Rose's Law, it comes from a little girl who you can probably guess her name is Rosa, and she's lived in Maryland and she has Down syndrome, and this law became a thing because she was bullied. Kids in school were calling her retarded and using that word, and so it started with her parents starting a bill to change the terminology that's associated with that. So in 2010, President Obama passed this law, which eliminates the word retarded and retardation in federal health, education, and from labor laws. And so the bill changed the term mental retardation to intellectual disability, and mentally retarded individual to individual with intellectual disability. And the wording of that second phrase is very important, how it starts with individual with an intellectual disability, because that's something that we use in the special education world, which is called person first language. So you always want to make sure when you're talking about someone with a disability that you're putting who they are before their disability. So instead of saying the autistic girl, you say the girl with autism, because you're a person before your disability. That's not what defines them. And so now that the terminology has been changed, the larger goal for all of us is to target the social stigma and negative perceptions that surround people with intellectual disabilities. And lastly, spread the word to end the word. So this is a nationwide movement to end the R word. So rword.org explains a little more in depth what it's about. So they say, our campaign asks people to pledge to stop saying the R word as a starting point towards creating more accepting attitudes and communities for all people. Language affects attitudes, and attitudes affect actions. Pledge today to use respectful people first language. So again, it talks about the people first language and just how your words can affect people. And then another way to become part of the solution to this problem is to join clubs just around campus or anywhere. So two clubs I'm a part of are Best Buddies and Autism Speaks, which I know there are also more on campus. And these just give you a chance to become more acquainted with disabilities and give you a chance to gain knowledge and become more comfortable with people who have disabilities, then you know more about it. And now I'm going to show you a short video that's just some high school students talking about the R word. Thank you.
down the bottom on your toolbar.
Sorry.
The X. Nope.
Yeah, it's a screw.
It's gone.
Just move the mouse on the screen. There you go.
Okay.
Down next to Internet Explorer.
Nope. Over here on the X.
Oh, please. Down here?
On the right.
See the X?
It's application that's open between Chrome and Internet Explorer.
Oh, well,
see,
that's not
mine.
Okay.
And then
I'll
mute it.
That's my lap.
No worries. Just hit that off the other.
Okay.
And then don't X. No.
Oh,
I should have
told you that. Oh, no,
I'm so sorry.
Now it's going down here.
Oh, it's gone.
Just finish. That's fine.
That was fine. I should have told you
that. So, that's a nice video of some high school students. It just is them basically showing you that they have intellectual disabilities, but they're just like us, and we can find ways to relate to each other. And, yes. So I challenge you to all choose different words and think about who you're affecting when you speak.